Hi everybody and welcome to our latest Bitesize APC Mandatory Competency Expert webinar. And this time we're going to be covering all of the senior professional assessment mandatory competencies. I'm just going to begin with a word of warning. I think that senior professional assessment is the hardest route to APC. So if you're doing it, please be 100% sure that you fit the role, you've got the right experience, especially for these three senior professional mandatory competencies. And the three mandatory competencies that are specific to the senior professional route, and the three mandatory competencies that are specific to the senior professional assessment, are leadership, managing people, and managing resources. But managing resources excludes human resources. And all candidates must do up to a minimum of level 2. And in this webinar, we're just going to explore the level 1 and level 2 requirements of these three competencies. First of all, leadership at level 1 looks at leadership theory. So you're going to need to know what a leader is, how a leader creates an inspiring vision, how they motivate and inspire people to engage with that vision, how you manage the delivery of the vision, and how you coach and build a team so that that team is more effective in achieving the vision. And also you'll need an awareness of the different theories of leadership, such as a trait theory. And a trait theory of leadership helps you to identify your traits and qualities. For example, are you assertive? Are you a good decision maker? Are you likeable? And what traits do you have that are helpful when leading others? Next one are behavioural theories. And these can be summed up by asking, what does a good leader do? An example of this is the work done by Kurt Lewin in the 1930s, who was a German-American psychologist. He developed a framework behaved on a leader's behaviour. And he argued that there's three types of leader. An autocratic leader that makes decisions themselves without consulting the team. Democratic leaders that allow the team to provide the leader with input before making a decision. And a laissez-faire leader who doesn't interfere and they allow people within the team to make their own decisions. But the laissez-faire leadership model needs experts within the team to make these decisions for you. Another type of leader uses the contingency theory, where situations influence good leadership. So there's no set way of leadership, it's leadership appropriate to that situation. And finally, power and influence theories. What is the source of the leader's power? And these are the different ways that leaders use power to influence what gets done. And models can be leading by example, transactional approach, and French and Raven's five forms of power, which is a model that highlights three types of positional power: legitimate, reward, and coercion. So leadership theory is a whole world of study by itself, and this is why you need to be actually a senior level and hopefully had some management training to understand level 1. Now level 2 is applying the leadership theory, devising strategy for leadership, and also measuring performance for this leadership. The next competency is managing people. And at level 1, a lot of this is human resources theory and legislation. Now, in terms of theory, the main one is, of course, Maslow's hierarchy of needs. There's already a webinar around learning Maslow's hierarchy of needs on our YouTube channel, and I'll put the link to this webinar in the description below. But also know the functions of human resources. And these functions include talent acquisition and recruitment, pay management and negotiation, benefits administration, training and development of staff, performance, appraisal and management of this, employee and labour relations, and compliance management. But you need to be actively involved in managing people. Even if you're relying on an internal human resources function in your organisation, you're going to still have to know the level 1 theory. Level two is applying this legislation, and it could be in recruitment, exiting people from your organisation, and managing people within their contract of employment, and also managing your team's performance. And the final senior professional assessment mandatory competency is on managing resources, which excludes human resources. We've already done a webinar on the APC accounting principles competency, and I'll put a link to that in the description below. But for this competency, you need to know the theory behind and also deliver. Are you monitoring for the financial performance for your organisation, such as using key financial statements, aged debtors, trial balance, inventory records, using working capital statements and financial ratios, and using fund and cash flow statements? And are you analysing overheads, marketing expenses, human resources? Are you creating dashboards to show this information, or are you managing a team that creates these dashboards for you? And are you carrying out competitive analysis of how you manage resources to maybe some set benchmarks? As I said, be very careful if you're considering doing the senior professional assessment. It's not impossible, but you need to be at a very senior level, at a decision-making level, not necessarily running your own firm. It is for people who are movers and shakers in the industry, but they've still got to know the other mandatory requirements, and deliver the other mandatory competencies and the competencies within your pathway, but maybe slightly distance from the day-to-day technical work due to their senior level and their leadership level. But the candidates still need to know the technical subjects and delivering them at a managerial level. If you found this webinar useful, please subscribe to our channel. And as always, good luck with your APC, and thanks for watching.